Good morning, guys. Starting my day off up in Lynchburg, Virginia. Getting ready to drop off in about 30 more minutes. And, man, it's really been a rough week. To be honest, it's been a rough summer. But what I got on here to talk about was the PS Pro. What once we thought was going to be PS4 Neo. But we got Pro. What I called making this video about, I was pissed like everybody else. I just want a new system. I wasn't really caring about the frame rate because I'm not a tech geek, but I do like my hardware, my electronics. And I have a 4K Sony TV, and now they start to come out with physical media of Blu-ray movies. I really want a 4K Blu-ray disc player, but we didn't get it. But for a long time, I've never been an Xbox fan, but for a change, Xbox really has something I like. I hate Xbox. I don't even like how the controller feel big and clunky to me. Our hell's been a PlayStation, from Nintendo to PlayStation, where I went to, and that's where I want to stay. But like I said, I was griping with it, like with everybody else about the system. Complaining, what the hell, because all of us been waiting for the longest for them to reveal this system. When we got it, we felt disappointed, like we didn't get what we asked for. Even though it do got a 4.2 teraflop put in it, it really is an upgrade. And now we got HDR, dynamic range. Pretty good, pretty beautiful. Matter of fact, this Monday, my old PS4 just upgraded up to HDR. I'm a truck driver, but I have not seen what it's capable of yet, because I'm on the road and my 4K TV at the house. But when I get home, I will be finding out what it play like. And I just ordered an Xbox One S. I didn't order it for the gaming console. I ordered for the 4K Blu-ray player. Like I said, I'm not too big up on Xbox. And the only games I probably will be playing on it is Xbox exclusive games. Like Gears of War 4, FIFA 3 and all. Stuff like that. That's all I care about. Other than that, I'm not going to be playing this and that. Because I got the Madden Edition, Xbox S, and I already have Madden on PS4. So I'm not going to switch brand name and try to make another game on another console. So what I would do, I would just trade my Madden off to GameStop and put it towards Gears of War 4. That's what I think I'm going to do. Other than that, that's all I have used for Xbox. Now, like I said, I was pissed off with PS4 just like everybody else. Complaining, whining, titty baby. Yeah, I did it. But more I started to think about it once I watched some other people that made some key points and key reviews. Really, it's a business decision, and it's, in a way, it's kind of like a smart decision. See, Microsoft is all about computers. Sony is about TVs and all other different type of platforms. They got a 4K Blu-ray player should be coming out in April. Now, if they put that 4K Blu-ray player in a PS4 Pro, it will put a damper on their sale when the 4K Blu-ray player come out. So I think that's the reason why they made that choice. Now, remember, they can update this system. Just like they did when PS4 first came out, it wasn't able to play 3D Blu-ray movies. But now it can, because they did an update. So you got to stay open-minded on this. Because it always can change. So, like I said, I'm getting a S by S. I might end up selling them. If they update the PlayStation, I might end up selling it in the long run. I don't know if I'm 100% just keeping Xbox. Because I'm not just a big fan of Xbox. And you got all these people whining about, Xbox Scorpio, it's going to be the most powerful system on the market. It's going to be shooting for native 4K games. PlayStation don't do that. Okay, cool. It's the most powerful system on the block. That's good. Then everybody thought, oh, gonna have backwards compatibility. Cool. Gonna have backwards compatibility. But I'm gonna tell you like this right now. You think I give a hoop by going back and playing a PS3 game and a PS2 game? No, I don't care. I want the top-notch best graphical games out there today on the market. I don't care about going back playing some old vintage game. Don't care. If I want to play that, I just would have kept my PS2 and my PS3. Don't care about that. Now, a lot of things people have not realized, you get an Xbox Scorpio that's supposed to have 6 teraflops in it, supposed to have native 4K in it, supposed to be the most powerful system on the console on the market when it comes. But everybody whining about 4K. Now, you think Bungie gonna make a 4K game for Xbox like Destiny and double back down and make a regular version game, just stream hot damn damn rain for PS4? I'd be crazy. The company will be losing money. You cannot make 2 games for 2 different consoles. Doom games, that game got to be made the same spec. That game should be able to play on the other system too. So they're not gonna just make a 4K gaming, native 4K game just to play on the Xbox and then come back here and they gotta make a whole other game over again, the same game, so it can play on the Pro. That's crazy. So, what I'm getting at, folks, and you think about you gonna play a native 4K game, and like a lot of people say, a lot of people don't have 4K TVs. Fortunately, I do. You think you're gonna get a native 4K game? You are not really gonna get a native 4K game to PS4 and come out with the PS5. That's about when you gonna get it. Because then they be building a whole new console to push native 4K. So now the post console can be on the same playing field and develop. Can make the same game for both consoles. If you do get a native 4K game for the Neo, the Scorpio, it because it's an Xbox exclusive game. That's the only way I can see you getting a 4K game for the Xbox. And it's gonna have to be Xbox exclusive. Now, it's never going to come to PS4. That's the only way. Dedicated. I've been hearing guys, they got a rib to screw. Because a lot of people are sitting right here chittering, chatting, saying Gears of War is a native 4K game. And FIFA 3 is a native 4K game. No, that is a lie. It just had HDR calibrability. Just like
behind me and